My question for you is, how do you know if changing a CSS property is expensive?
Like, painting expensive?
Not just paint, we're talking layout, we're talking paint, we're talking composite. These things, developers, they talk about this all the time, like, how do I know if I'm doing something that's gonna cause me a bottleneck, if it's a problem? How do you know?
It's normally just a matter of do it and test it.
It was, but it's not anymore, Jake. Good news, I've made a website, CSSTriggers.com. Yay, woo! CSSTriggers.com.
CSS Triggers?
Yes, .com. And it's a bit pluggy, isn't it, that?
This is not like trigger warning.
Well, it could be, depending on how upset you get over CSS.
Yes, which can be quite upsetting, especially if it's causing performance issues.
Ah, I like what you did, you brought it right back in. Yeah, anyway, so the idea is you hit the site, it's got all the CSS properties, you can search for the one you're interested in, and it will tell you whether it triggers layout, paint, composite, all of the above.
These are different things. Are there things that I would change that only affect one of those things? Like, give me an example of something that only affects painting, but not the other things.
Painting, background size, box shadow, text shadow. They do that because they don't change the layout of the page in any way, right? They don't change the geometry of the page, right. The widths, heights, anything to do with the elements' actual sizes.
So there are ones that do it the other way around as well?
So it's more like a waterfall. If you change layout, which is going to be changing the widths, heights, basically the geometry of the page, paddings, margins, all that kind of stuff, you'll change the geometry of the page, and that will dirty some pixels which will need to be repainted, and then you'll need to composite the page. Or you change something which causes a paint to happen, and then you'll have to composite the page. Or you change something which just causes the page to be recomposited. So it's a sort of a stepping process.
Okay. When you gathered this data, was this just from memory and experience?
Nope. I'm glad you asked. I made the mother of all test suites. It was fantastic. And then I used telemetry to kind of step through them and figure out what was what. But I used will change, which was brand new and very exciting, basically to say, I will be changing opacity. I will be changing box shadow. You tell me when I do this, what it triggered. And DevTools just went, you know what? I did a bit of layout there, did a bit of paint. Anyway, if you want to see how your CSS affects performance, what work it's going to trigger, just go over to the site and have a look.
Oh, cool. And is that for every browser or?
Other browsers are incoming. Today it's only Chrome.
Cool. And that's, what's the site name? Because I wasn't listening to you properly.
Really?
No, I really wasn't. You should say it again, just for my benefit.
Just your benefit?
Just my benefit.
Excellent. I'm glad we're having this conversation, my friend. CSSTriggers.com. Yay, woo!
Keyboards, like the computer ones, not the musical ones. You've used one before, right?
No. Yes.
Yes, I've seen you. I've seen you in the office. Now, I imagine there was a point where keyboard manufacturers thought, right, we need to solve this problem, right? We need to give them a key to press when they've hit the wrong key and they want to undo that error of theirs, right? And they called this the backspace key.
Right.
So this key that you're supposed to press when you've, you know, gone off by one, hit the wrong key, want to correct it, where did they put this key?
Right next to the return enter key.
Right next to the key that says, no, actually, everything is great. I want to ship that text off to a colleague, right? A colleague asked for some help, and I wrote, because I was a little bit busy at the time, give me a sec. And I was like, ah, oh, did it wrong. Went to press the backspace key, ka-chung, enter. Off to the colleague, off to their phone goes, give me a sex. Like it was a demand. So I want to talk about pointer events.
Hooray!